Hello, space fans, and welcome to Your Sky Tonight. My name is Tony Darnell from deepastronomy.space. This week, after setting our clocks back an hour and the night sky takes center stage in our early evening hours in the Northern Hemisphere, we're going to take a look at one of the most distant objects that can be seen with the naked eye, the Triangulum Galaxy. Rising in the east shortly after sunset, the constellation Triangulum appears. The constellation itself is hard to find because it consists of only a triangle, and we can make out many of those in our connect the dots patterns that make up the constellations. So the easiest way to find Triangulum is to look for the great square in the constellation Pegasus. I know, finding a square is also really easy to do, and there appear to be many of those as well. But this one is very bright and sits relatively close to the distinctive constellation of Cassiopeia. So, after locating the Great Square of Pegasus, follow it down toward the horizon and past Andromeda. And if you are out on a very dark night, you'll also see the Andromeda Galaxy in between Cassiopeia and Andromeda. The constellation Triangulum itself is an unremarkable dim triangle, but it is home to a remarkable object, the Triangulum Galaxy, or M33. This galaxy is actually visible to the naked eye on very dark nights. Like the Andromeda Galaxy, it appears as a faint smudge that is best viewed using your peripheral vision. That's the part of your eye that is most sensitive to very dim grayscale things. The galaxy appears between the triangle and the bright star in Andromeda called Mirac, and you may have noticed its close proximity in the sky to the Andromeda Galaxy. That's because the Triangulum Galaxy is a member of our local group of galaxies that include Andromeda and the Milky Way. In fact, the Triangulum Galaxy is the third largest in our local group, and many astronomers think it is gravitationally bound to Andromeda. It is a little farther away from us than the Andromeda Galaxy. The Triangulum is approximately 3 million light years from us, while Andromeda is only 2.5 million light years away. Here is an image of M33 taken with amateur equipment, and here is one taken from the Very Large Telescope in South America, which shows glowing red gas in the spiral arms. This galaxy is 60,000 light years across and contains some 40 billion stars. By comparison, our galaxy, the Milky Way, is home to over 400 billion stars. If the Triangulum Galaxy is in fact linked with Andromeda, as many astronomers believe, then we can expect this galaxy to also take part in an amazing galactic collision in a little over 2.5 billion years between the Andromeda Galaxy, the Triangulum Galaxy, and our own Milky Way galaxy. When this occurs, all three will be torn apart by gravitational tidal forces and will gradually reform into a larger galaxy, perhaps producing one of the largest in the universe, a mighty elliptical. So go outside tonight on this crisp fall evening and look toward the east early in the evening and try to find this nondescript triangular constellation called Triangulum. Well, that's it for now, space fans. Thank you all for listening. And as always, keep looking up. Astronomy is sponsored by The Great Courses Plus, a subscription on-demand video learning service where space fans can enjoy lectures in astronomy from top professors from around the world. I particularly recommend Exoplanets, What Astronomers Know by Dr. Joshua Wynn. Go to thegreatcoursesplus.com/deepastronomy to get a free 1 month trial to check out all the great stuff they have. And you can support Deep Astronomy by getting a subscription. I think space fans everywhere will get a lot out of their courses.